is really the thing that's really taking over. Mm-hmm. I think there's still those, you know, sites that are done, you know, strictly HTML and mm-hmm. CSS, but they're, people want to see animation. Mm-hmm. And students are getting, a lot of my students are getting work doing that. Mm-hmm. It's very in demand mm-hmm. right now.
When students come into your class at Channel Islands, mm-hmm. What are some of the biggest misconceptions they might have about web design and working in new media?
That it's like doing print, mm-hmm. which is a completely different mm-hmm. genre, you know.
In what way?
When you're doing a brochure or you're doing a pamphlet or something, you would design in a different way than you would for the web. For the web, you have the dimensions of someone's monitor, and you have to consider that, and what's going to be what we call above the fold, like mm-hmm. you're reading a newspaper, what the pertinent information should be above the fold, and capturing the audience and not having them click away mm-hmm. if they don't get what they are looking for when they go to a certain website.
And what makes people click away?
If they don't get the information they want right away, maybe they you bury it so deep mm-hmm. in the pages that they mm-hmm. it takes too long to find mm-hmm. it. So and a good navigation to click on something and it takes you where you want to go and, okay. and back and forth.
Okay. Yeah. And what do students bring to your class that you're really happy that they have? What sort of knowledge do they?
Well, over the years, it's nice to see, you know, their ideas. I mean, they're young and they're, you know, they have different influences that they see mm-hmm. and that they're thinking about. So they bring that freshness to mm-hmm. the web that I love to see every year. I see something new and exciting coming out.
Let's take a look. We're kind of cutting back and forth as we look at your work, and I'm not sure if we have any more websites. There we are. Mm-hmm. What is this one here?
Oh, this is for a client who he had different domain names: Ion Channels, Ion Sports, a whole bunch of different things. Yeah, that was when it was in development.
This is going back
to... Yeah, this is back to the Nick Harcourt site.
Maybe we can click on this one and see if...
Just a simple animation. A lot of clients don't want too much animation. They just want, you know, to be able to
And that was one of the things I wanted to ask you. Mm-hmm. At what point do you have so many bells and whistles that you begin to lose sight of what you're trying to convey?
Yeah, sometimes you do, because it depends on, like, if you're doing your own personal site and you want to have all those bells mm-hmm. and whistles and animation and all that, you know, go for it. Mm-hmm. But sometimes a corporate client will not want all that mm-hmm. animation. Although, you know, lately I've been looking at, you know, NBC's site mm-hmm. and site for the Olympics mm-hmm. and you see them using Flash in different areas.
Lots of stuff, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And video, I mean, with Flash now you can incorporate video very easily, so you see that.
Yeah, I look at the New York Times website every mm-hmm. day, and that's now I'm counting on having a little video clip
right.
to go along. And it's interesting, it's often, you know, produced as a video clip rather than just as a one-off thing from the story itself. Mm-hmm. What do you think is the most successful website that you have ever designed in the course of your career, and why?
Well, I worked for a while doing graphics for KCRW site. Now, this is about 6 years ago or more. They have a new website now, but I really enjoyed working on that website because of all the content that was involved mm-hmm. in that site. And kind of also, I learned a lot there when I, you know, worked there.
So you felt a passion for the material that you were
mm-hmm.
trying to show.
Very much so.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we've got about 5 minutes left.
Sure.
Let's move to you, Liz King, the visual artist who's mm-hmm. who's also someone who makes her living, doing web design. Talk to me a little bit about your own work and what you've been trying to do lately.
Yeah, lately I've kind of been trying to go back to bringing together my fine artwork mm-hmm. and digital. So bringing that full circle, incorporating my drawings with work that I do in Photoshop mm-hmm. and Illustrator, and bringing that together and then printing it and, you know,
And then
put it in shows. Yeah. And exhibiting it, right?
So we have a couple of images. Mm-hmm. The first one is called March. Talk me through how this came about.
Right. That is a piece that it is started out with a charcoal drawing, black and white charcoal drawing, and then when I went back into it digitally and added to it.
And did you know you were going to do that as you were making the charcoal drawing?
Oh, no.
No.
Not at all.
Was it a recent drawing?
The drawing was a few years ago, uh-huh. and then, you know, going back into it was recent,
okay.
very recent.
So you thought there's something lacking from this right now? Or
I just thought I would reinvestigate, uh-huh. you know, what might happen if I went back into it with, you know.
As we're looking at this image, what's the Photoshop element? What's the second?
Just using the tablet, using the different brushes and different tools that are available in Photoshop, and mm-hmm. also some of the, you know, you can make things more saturated,
okay.
really more intense.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Do you ever feel like you're cheating by going and doing that?
No, I don't. You know, if you had asked me a few years ago, maybe yeah, I would say yeah. But no, I don't, because it's still my own hand
right.
doing the.
And there's a bigger palette, as it were, available
yeah.
to an artist now.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
So this is March. Is a black and white. It's dark, mm-hmm. like as you said, a lot of your early work.
Mm-hmm.
Is this something that you're trying to break out of?
The black and white. Yeah, actually, one of my most recent pieces that's in a show right now in Carpinteria is reintroducing color back into it. So it's a piece called Botanica.
Yeah, we'll take a look at that.
Right,
yeah.
And it's bright greens. Some photography elements are in there, and I incorporated a frame element in the center with veins.
Why veins?
I was working on this piece. I was actually at a writing retreat with the university, and I was working, and I was like, what do I put in the center there? I needed something there in the center. And I actually, one of my colleagues, she's a nursing professor, walked by, and she saw all the other kind of branches. I had a whole bunch of branches in there. She goes, oh, those look like veins. And it hit me. And I started to look for imagery that was related to that, and I found the perfect image incorporated in. It was just what I wanted. Yeah.
So, and what are you working on right now? What are your other works, new pieces that you've got going?
I have similar pieces mm-hmm. to that. I have one that it's kind of looks like an octopus with snakes. My students know this about me. Like when I give an assignment, sometimes I'm very interested in like snakes and insects, and it just I don't know. There's something very interesting about you know. Life like that, the legs, the uh-huh. arms, the, you know, just kind of a little terrifying a little bit. But
And you've also been involved with Santa Barbara Printmakers, too.
Yes, yes,
I'm in that group. Talk about that experience.
Oh, it's a great group. I often show prints with them. They just had a show in Ojai, mm-hmm. That was the summer, and they're going to have a show coming up in the fall, and it's just a dynamic group of printmakers, mm-hmm. so...
When you have a piece that you know is going to go in a show with them, what are you thinking? Is there a specific type of piece that you're looking for? Just something recent?
Yeah, something recent. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, anything that I feel like I want to, you know, they have a juried show, so that I want to put in there and see if it'll get considered. Yeah.
Well, it's great to see this big range of your work, Liz. Thanks so much for being on the show.
Thank you so much. It's been a pleasure.
Creative Community is produced by Santa Barbara City College in association with the Santa Barbara Channels. I'm David Starkey, and we'll see you next time.